Welcome to our intro to SPAPI roles. This video is designed for developers who are requesting roles for their Selling Partner API developer profile. Developers may also find this video helpful when selecting roles for an SPAPI application. In what follows, we define what SPAPI roles are and explain how they determine access to selling operations and resources. We also explain how to add roles to an existing developer profile and offer troubleshooting tips. Let's start with an overview of SPAPI roles and access. SPAPI roles are used by Amazon to group and grant access to various selling operations and resources. For example, the product listing role provides access to a range of operations that selling partners use to create and manage listings in the Amazon store. Developers request access to roles from Amazon in order to add them to their developer profile. This happens when they first register as an SPAPI developer. If you'd like more information about the registration process, refer to our video, Register as an SPAPI Developer. Once you're approved for a role and it appears in your profile, you can select it for any relevant application you want to integrate with SPAPI. This happens when you first register the application. You can select every role in your developer profile for a particular application, or choose just one if your application has a smaller scope. Select roles based on your application's requirements, which should align with the needs of the selling partner you're collaborating with. If you'd like more information about registering an application, refer to the first video in our Integrate with SPAPI series, Step 1, Register an Application for SPAPI. After roles are selected for an application, you'll self-authorize the application if it's private. Or for a public application, your selling partner will review the roles selected and provide authorization. Both processes occur directly after app registration. After authorization, your application can access all the operations and resources grouped under the roles selected. For more information about the authorization process, refer to the relevant Step 2 module in our Integrate with SPAPI series. It's important to note that your application can only access a role and its associated operations and resources after being authorized. Even if you have access to a role as a developer and can view it in your developer profile, access isn't granted to your application until authorization is complete. In addition to regulating access to selling operations and resources, SPAPI roles limit an application's access to the personally identifiable information, or PII, of Amazon customers. Most roles ensure that an application, its developer, and the selling partners who use it receive no access to PII or other sensitive customer information. Those that grant access are labeled restricted, and they limit PII access to what's required for the application. Limiting access in this way helps secure the privacy of Amazon shoppers and establishes trust between them, Amazon, and the selling partners and developers who use SPAPI. In order to access restricted roles and the operations and resources grouped under them, you must provide additional information about your data use and security controls during developer registration. A new field will appear after you select a restricted role. For more information about each restricted and unrestricted SPAPI role, visit the Selling Partner API documentation website and select Roles in the Selling Partner API from the table of contents. Now that you're more familiar with SPAPI roles, let's troubleshoot some common issues. If you're registering an application for SPAPI and a relevant role you want to select is missing from the app registration form, this likely means it's not yet included in your developer profile. To check your profile, sign in to Developer Central. If you're integrating a public application, you should sign in directly at developercentral.amazon.com. If you're integrating a private application, you should sign in to Developer Central through your Seller Central or Vendor Central account. After signing into Seller Central, select Partner Network from the main menu. Then click Develop Apps to access Developer Central. After signing into Vendor Central, select Integration from the main menu, then click API Integration. Next, on your Developer Central homepage, click View Profile. If the box next to a role on the Developer Profile form is unchecked, that role isn't included in your current profile. Check the box, then resubmit your profile for evaluation by clicking the Register button. Once approved, the role will appear in your Developer Profile and you'll be able to select it for your application. After doing so, make sure you reauthorize your application if you already authorized it without the role. When you reauthorize, generate a new LWA refresh token to make a valid API call. Another issue developers sometimes encounter is error code 403, unauthorized access denied. This can appear in response to an API request made by a registered application. If you receive error 403, try these three tips. Tip 1. Have the seller whose account you're making the request to confirm that their account has a healthy status. They can check their Seller Central homepage for an alert or select Performance, then Account Health from the menu to review their full account status. If a seller's account isn't healthy, they aren't able to use SPAPI, but they can improve their status to gain access. Tip 2. Confirm with the selling partner that the account you're making the request to is in the region associated with the endpoint you're using to call SPAPI. Although your application is global, seller accounts are regional and vendor accounts are store-specific. If the selling partner's region is North America, make sure your endpoint is https://sellingpartneraPI-na.amazon.com. If it's Europe, make sure your endpoint is https://sellingpartneraPI-eu.amazon.com. And if the selling partner's region is Asia Pacific or APAC, make sure your endpoint is https://sellingpartneraPI-fe.amazon.com. Tip 3. Double check that your application has access to the API operation you're making the request to. Compare the roles you've selected for the application to the roles necessary for the API operation. This concludes our training on SPAPI roles. If you'd like to learn more, visit the Selling Partner API documentation website and select Roles in the Selling Partner API from the table of contents. Thanks for watching.